So you're trying to tell me you made a time machine out of a DeLorean?
No, sorry, Marty, I didn't, because the Chinese government has banned time travel here.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jon Paula, and on today's episode, I would like to talk about time travel being banned on Chinese television. Fans of the program here, of course, know that I am a huge fan of time travel. It is a very exciting and interesting, and quite frankly, just a flat-out entertaining subject to discuss, to watch, and enjoy in our fictional media. Movies, comic books, TV shows, whatever. Unfortunately, the communist Chinese government has issue with that, and on March 31st of this year, the State Administration of Radio, Film, and Television in China decided that it would no longer allow such plot lines and story dynamics. Specifically, they are now discouraging plot lines that contain elements of fantasy, time travel, random compilations of mythical stories, bizarre plots, absurd techniques, even propagating feudal superstitions, fatalism and reincarnation, ambiguous moral lessons, and a lack of positive thinking. Congratulations, China. You basically are like the wet blanket of the world now. You have to rain on everybody's parade. It's like, hey, I have a great idea for a movie. Oh, wait. Oh, it's exciting. Oh, it's fun. Interesting in some way. Oh, it doesn't have a happy ending. Oh, sorry. You can't make it in China anymore because they're the man and you can't fight the man if you're Chinese, apparently. The Chinese government says that TV drama shouldn't have characters that travel back in time and rewrite history because it goes against Chinese heritage. They also say that myths, superstitions, and reincarnation are, quote, questionable. I mean, there you have it. That's all you need to know, and quite frankly, it's not that surprising. We've already heard in the past that China has banned Google and YouTube and some other sites in their country for certain reasons. I mean, God forbid the youth of their country grow up and learn about Tiananmen Square and what used to happen before they were alive. Or, God forbid, anything that happened in their lifetime that goes against the wishes of the state. So, this isn't necessarily surprising to me, but it is interesting that they've gone so far to legally specify against, quote, time travel, myths, you know, creatures, and, like, they're very, very specific over there about their law, which to me is fascinating as an American, because here it's just like, you know, play ball so long as there aren't tits. And while, you know, some American censorship is certainly questionable, just time travel? Moral lessons? That seems like you're really drawing the fine line to a point where you're not only stunting creativity, you're just outright blocking it from ever rearing its head again. So, for those of my audience who are watching this movie in China, congratulations, you've got around all of your IP blocks. And second, I feel sorry for you because you live in a country devoid of quantum leap, and that is a terrible place to live. In any event, this is an interesting story. And I would normally end the video by saying, you know, it's an interesting story and I'd love to follow up and see where it goes from here, but we all know that it's only going to go downhill. It's going to get worse and worse. China's not going to relax their state on this in a little bit. They're not going to open up about it. Time travel's gone in China. It's too bad. What, though, happens to American-made movies like Back to the Future or Time Cop, Terminator 2? Are these movies that are also banned in China? Or do they have some sort of grandfather law that because they were made outside of China and before this restriction, are they still allowed to be shown? Because that would be really terrible if 1.2 billion people were no longer able to learn and love the ways of Doc Brown and Marty McFly. In any event, please let me know what you think about this story in the comments down below. But for me, for now, those are my thoughts on the Chinese banning time travel. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.